fossil from back and forth to his animal life, and he did. And one fall time, my sister Wolf and I were working in a field. My brother Joel, he said, you could do the hay by hand. We used a long knife that's called machete, and we were cutting hay for the horses. And I must have been about 2.5 miles out in the field. And also brought this guy to the cabin, and we just thought, well, another hunter, huh? So we just, and all of a sudden, Angie flew closer to us, and we could see them waving, and they're going like this. And Ruth stopped what she was doing, and said, Louise, she said, I think they're calling you. And Joe, who was closer to Angus, and Angus yelled at Joe and said, yeah, they said they want her to come. Before Brother Branham entered the cabin, he stopped and he looked around. And he said to Oscar, he said, have you got a sister named Louise? And Oscar was shocked. And he said, yes, she's standing in the field right there. He said, well, tell her to come here, he said. Now, Lila never told Bob Branham my name or anything, no? It's just, well, you know. And I thought, well, I'll to speak good English. Why would he need me, yeah? So I come across the field not knowing, you know. And we didn't even know Mom was sick except Austin. And yeah, they knew she was going, but they wouldn't tell them. So I walked up to him. I was from here to sister there, and just walking that far, and he said, behold the handmaiden of the Lord, he said. I was surprised. I thought, you know. And he told me to, my name is Bob Branham. He said, I pray for the people, you know, and I shook hands with them. And, you know, when you're young, you just don't concentrate on anything, yeah? Me, I got plans. I was going to go and give him. But I, at that time, I didn't know God had another plan that I wasn't aware of. I didn't know those things happened. Anyway, we got into the cabin. All I thought was, well, I wish you'd pray for Mom and just get it over with, you know. And anyway, we were standing at the foot of the bed. I think Mom passed away because she could no longer talk to us. And I called her, she wouldn't answer. She was just laying like that. And Dad have we live in a cabin, and it's got a cardboard wall, and my brother's got a bad habit of writing on the wall. And I thought Brother Branham was reading something on the wall. You know, nobody told me to see vision or anything like that, huh? And he looked at her, over her, and then he looked right straight at something like, I thought he was looking on the wall and he was reading something, and he said her daughter is going to the city, you know. Anyway, I thought somebody's been talking about it. Her daughter's going to the city to be an RN. And he was pointing at me like this. Before then, I was supposed to engage to this guy that I wasn't aware of. He knew, but I didn't know. Anyway, he said, you'll not have that nursing training with you. You're not going to have it. And also, the man you had in mind for getting me, said, it's not for you. I said, how did this man know everything? So, and then he told me to ask, and he said, be a nurse for the Lord Jesus Christ, he said. And he prayed for her. He said, tell your mom if I pray for her, she believes she's going to be well. And I did tell Mom, and she just nodded her head, and she went back like that. And that was it, and I thought, well, I turned my back to him, and I walked around the store. I thought, gee, and he put, he got his hat on, and he said, well, Jesus Christ is not welcome, I am not, he said. So I turned around, I said, I did believe, you know, the Lord. And that's when he looked over, he saw the vision about me. And he said three names. Now, I can't, I caught the first name, but not these two. And he said, you're the princess of Zion. And I thought, what is this man saying, you know? You know, like, you know yourself, he could read your mind, right? With that, he took his hat off, put it on his heart, he walked out the door. That's the first time I met Paul's man. Being in the presence of the prophet, you know, it changed my life. I think I was walking on air like this for 30 years. I couldn't, there's no way I could come down. And here everybody was, you know, like even Mom told my sister, she said, check this stuff. She said, you must be secretly drinking, otherwise you wouldn't be so calm. And she was so worried about me. She said, why wouldn't she, like, I'm forward, what you would call a forward. Like, before anybody could say, Louise knows everything. She's got the answer. You don't have to tell her anything. I was outspoken, huh? But after that, everything changed. And if I came to come to visit the family, I'll ask them, well, tell me first, and then I'll tell the rest of the family. But this time, I wasn't like that. And Mom was talking about it to the family one day. He said, gee, I wonder what happened. Why is he so different now? And here's Oscar. He said, well, he said, you were worried about her. You wanted somebody to talk to her. He said, the prophet fixed her for good people. That Oscar's statement, he said, the prophet fixed her for good. Yeah. Ever since then, I've been a changed person. I never was the same again, you know. And I thank God for my life crossing here. Without him, I think I would have been, you know, I would have been like other girls, and I'm afraid I wouldn't even be living today. But I'm very happy. That's the happiest moment. You know, it changed my life. And I just want to encourage the ones that are coming up, the younger generations, especially to say, press on. God is not mocked. You know, everything you said is truth. So just, even the going gets rough, you know, just keep on. And about my brother, about Brother Branham crossed the Granite Creek, that's where we were baptized. And my brother Horace, I think broke his leg or something, and Hanky said to Joe, he said, you better get rid of that horse. And Joe said, no. So Joe got an idea. He's unlearned too, my brother. But he believed. He took a pail of water, took a pail down to the creek, and said, Lord, your prophet crossed this creek. And he said, he prayed for the family. He said, no, I'm praying for my horse. He said, if you just have mercy on my horse, he said, I would be grateful. I need him to carry me back home 20 miles in a bush. So that whole horse was laying there, and he drove, pick up the pail of water, and just put it over the horse that gets kind of baptized or something. And the horse got up, and going and popping, and I told Angus, he said, you better saddle that horse, you know? And Angus said, I told you to get rid of it. He said, no, he said, it's standing on his feet. Angus said, what happened? He said, me, just baptized him according to the word. He said, there he is.